Hi, in these videos, we're going to draw a temporary barrier rail. This is the end section, this is the standard section, and in between the rails are some bent rebar, that's the green ones, and a straight pin, the yellow one. And what this temporary barrier rail is used for, let's say you want to widen a bridge, and on this side here you're going to drive your cars, this side here the construction workers are going to be expanding the bridge. At the beginning of this video, I gave you a URL that gave you the path to the drawings for this temporary barrier rail. And you can see here's the standard shape right here, and we're going to draw that in a little while. If you go down a little bit, here's the steel that's inside the temporary barrier rail, so I'll just call it TBR. Here's the pin right here that holds them together. And down below is the end section details. We're going to start with the steel. So download these drawings or keep them on your other screen if you have a two-screen setup. We're just going to draw this pin. And if you actually look at it, this pin is bent up so that they tie in together so you can give really good strength in the TBR. We don't really need that because we're just drawing the look of it. So we want to draw this pin right here. It's 4 1/4 outside to outside, 2 3/4 inside radius or diameter. It's a number 6 bar. That means it's 3/4 inch in diameter. That's what a number 6 bar is. So we want to draw this, and I'm just going to make it, instead of 33, I'm just going to make it 30 inches long. So let's go over here, start with, just draw something 30 inches long, and if you go back to your drawing, it was 4 1/4 outside to outside. So you have to subtract away 3/4 inch to get the center line of it. So that leaves us 3 1/2. So let's move it over 3 1/2. And now if I take the arc tool, and I start one endpoint, and I go to the next endpoint, and just double click, I'll get the perfect arc that I want. All right. So now what we can do is on the end of it, we can draw a circle. And if I can see, I'm on the green axis. Now I'm on the blue axis. I want to keep it on the green, so I'm going to hold shift so it makes it hold it there. And I'm going to go to the end. And I'm going to draw a radius of 3/8. That's 1/2 3/4. Let's do 3/8. Enter. And there's my little circle. Now I can just select, if I go from the left or from the right and select everything, now I can go to this point here and hit my follow me tool, and I get a nice steel bar. So let's undo that, and let's look one other way. There's lots of plugins in the world, and you could go to something like pipe along path. So what you do is you select, you go pipe along path, you pick inches, you get a choice of inches or millimeters, outside diameter 0.75, inside diameter 0, circle, I want 24 segments to make the circle, and I go OK. And there is, oops, my steel bar. So let's just group it while we're here, and maybe I'll just paint it so I can see it. Really bright color. Green. It's epoxy coated. Epoxy coated is sort of a rubber coating you put on steel to protect it, and it's typically green. To use plugins, you have to put a file in the plugin directory. So typically, a plugin, I'll go to my downloads, pipe along path. If you look at it, a plugin is usually an RB extension. And all it is a text file, typically, that can help you do things in SketchUp. It's just a text file. So you take this file, go to your Google program. So I've got Google here, Google SketchUp 8, plugins, where is it? Right here, plugins. So you just put that RB file in plugins. And you can go to places like Sketchucation and find these RB files, and they really help you out, do a lot of different things in SketchUp. Alright, let's get back to this. So I grouped it. Yep. I'm just going to move it to the side because I don't need it right now. and bring back this piece. So what else do I need? I need this straight piece here with a little half-inch plate. And the half-inch plate is welded. You can see there's the weld symbol to the little bar. And the bar is, what size? 1 1/4 diameter bar. So the reason for that is it's just a pin you can slide down so you can move these really easy. So we're going to draw this plate really fast, 2 1/2 by 4 inches. All right, we'll just go back, move over, come on. You can just draw it really fast. 2 1/2 by 4. And obviously I should rotate that. And all I'm doing is I'm finding the middle. And if you go back, it says there's 1 3/8 of a diameter hole in the middle, so we'll just do that. And what is that? That's 11/8 divided by 1/2, so that's 11/16. Get rid of that. Extrude it 1/2 inch. And there's my plate, and I'm going to group it. And now I'm going to draw the bolt, and the bolt was 1 1/4, so I'm just going to draw that. One and a quarter, so 1.25 divided by 2. If you look at it, it's sticking up 2 1/2 above the top of the plate, and the plate's 1/2 inch, so it's going to be up 3 inches. And I've done something wrong there. So let's do that. Undo circle. So what's 1 1/4? What's 1/2 of that? So 4/4, 5/4, so it'd be 5/8 radius. 5 divided by 8. That probably looks a little better. 3 inches. The whole thing is 28 inches long, so I need to go 25 inches down. Oh, sometimes it just zooms too fast. So 25 inches down. And now I have my pin system. And I'm just going to group it. And I may paint it just so we can see it. So what color do I want to make it? I'll make it red. And this one here, I'll make it orange. All right. So what I've drawn is this pin system and these rebars right here. I can delete the guides. So that ends part one. In part two, we'll start on the main TBR.